place your ball, do you have a ball in your arm's reach? Place it between your thighs. Curl the tailbone up, lift up, hold it there, pull those ribs in, keep those arms nice and long. Squeeze the ball for 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, roll down. That's exercise one. Roll up, curl, lift all the way up, lengthen that right leg out, straight out, hold, 2, 3, now bend, switch the other leg out, hold, 2, 3, and bend, and roll all the way down. That's exercise two. You can do a number of those, right? Take the ball out, place it on the side, roll up. Ceiling, lengthen the leg forward, lift up, lengthen forward, lift up, lengthen forward, lift up, bend, switch, the other leg goes up, lengthen forward, lift up, forward, lift up, forward, lift up, bend, place it down, and roll down. That's the next one. Lengthen those legs out. Straight legs, arms up, head, neck, and shoulders, roll all the way up. Reach. Roll all the way down. And roll all the way up. Reach. Roll all the way up. Surprising enough, this roll up is very easy to do, right? Mm-hmm. Anybody can do it. It's easier than doing a roll up with the legs straight down. Okay.
So, what are you doing when somebody starts to cramp? You keep the class going, but you're gonna get that person to stand up and work out the cramp, their hamstrings.
Well, if somebody starts to cramp, you stop them right away and have them just pull their knees in, stretch if they need to get up. I haven't had anybody that cramps to the point where they need to stand up and walk.
Okay.
Usually, when someone is starting to cramp, they stop.
Right.
You know.
And then are they done with that series? Or can they?
No, they can do it.
Okay.
So you have to make adjustments,
okay.
Right? So you have to find adjustments for that person, because if they're cramping, depending where they're cramping, if they're cramping on their calf, that means that they're probably gripping their
right.
feet. So if they're cramping on their hamstrings, maybe they're going a little too high. You need to bring the feet a little bit further back, further up on top. You're going to hit the hamstrings a little harder, a little lower. You're going to use a little bit of, that's why this is good, because you can
down.
Push it. Yes,
yeah.
You
okay.
go down, go further out,
okay.
don't go as high. So,
yeah, okay, that's a good question.
Yeah, and have them stop. I mean, I had Vicky and Ann. Vicky cramps all the time.
Right.
So,
So
you have them just pull it in. I mean, if it's in a class, you have them stop. Take a break.
Okay.
Right? So you're going to pull those knees into your chest. You're going to sit up. You're going to turn around, and you're going to face the other way. Okay. So don't. Not up again. So just about. No. Keep the barrel all the way back. You're just going to pull yourself just a little bit further away from the barrel, but not too far, not too close.
Like a hand's distance.
A little bit more than a hand's. A hand's distance open. Hands behind your neck. Keep your legs together, feet down. Curl the tailbone up. Lengthen all the way back. Go back. And then just stretch out. So if you have your head supported, head, neck, and shoulders, and roll up. Roll up. And take it back. Curl the tailbone under. And roll back. Gently touch the barrel. Open the chest. Open. Stretch it out. Head, neck, and shoulders, and roll up. Okay, bring your hands down by your side. Go back a little bit closer to your barrel. There, hands behind your neck, and roll back. And take it back. And you can shoulders in, roll up. One more, and roll back. Open,
your barrel.
Just before you don't move the feet.
You can move the feet, yeah.
Hands behind your neck. And you can shoulders roll back.
There, are your arms touching the spring in the back?
Yeah.
There.
Mm-hmm.
Okay,
no.
So bring your feet closer to your buttocks. Open those legs a little bit, hip width. You're going to curl the tailbone up, and you're going to lift yourself into a full bridge, and you're going to look at your belly button. And I want those arms no longer to touch the springs behind you. So lift those arms a little bit in towards you, there. Yeah. So Kim, just lengthen the neck just a little bit and pull those arms up. Elbows up, yes, there. So those ribs are down. It's important that those ribs be down, that the neck stay long, and those hips, I don't want those hips completely up, I want it nice and flat. Hold it right there. There. Bring those feet a little, kid, lean a little closer. There, a little closer to each other. You're going to take your right leg up towards the ceiling. Don't move that hip. Uh-huh. Up to the ceiling. There. And bring it down. Place it down. You're looking for hip stability. You don't want the hip to drop. Take that other leg up. Now, don't start sinking that upper back. Lift up. Look at your belly button. There. Lift yourself up and bend. Place it down. And take the other leg up. Right leg up, up, and bring it down. Hip stability. Don't let that hip drop. And take the other leg up. Lift. Up, up.
I totally lost that one.
And bring it down. Hold. Now, keep the upper body exactly the way it is. You're going to start to roll down. Ribs into the barrel. Middle back into the barrel. So roll all the way down. Keep it there. Laying to the back. When your hip is down, head, neck, and shoulders, and roll up. There. And take it back down. And roll back. And lengthen back. And curl the tailbone up. Lift. Okay. And lift that upper body a little bit. Don't drop those hips. So if your people did this part okay, you can move on to the next. If they did not, you stop there and you can repeat that. The right leg goes up to the ceiling. You're going to place that leg all the way down into the mat. Place your heels down, soften those knees. So the heels are down, soften those knees. You're going to take that other leg and join the leg on the floor. And hold there. Uh-huh. Make sure those knees are soft. Make sure those heels are together. Uh-huh. Hold, hold the ribs in. You're sinking. Lift up more, more. Bend one knee, bend the right leg, place it down, bend the other leg, bring it down, and slowly roll all the way down. Ribs, middle back, lower back, all the way down, and roll up.
I thought something radical was coming.
Actually,
that was pretty nasty.
Okay, we're not done. Take it back.
Oh, okay.
You roll
I spoke
up.
Too soon.
Uh-huh, you take it back.
And curl, lift up. You guys can do more.
Lift the upper body up. Okay, you're going to take your left leg up to the ceiling. Up. You're going to take that leg long. Place the leg on the floor. Heels are, yes.
Soften those knees. Take that other leg and take it
out. Join the other one. Yes. Keep your knees soft. Don't go into an arch. So I want nice and flat. So get that upper body a little higher. Now. Full control, don't drop those hips. You're going to take the right leg up to the ceiling. Lift, up, and lower down. There, ribs in, and left leg up. Ribs are down, and right leg up, and down, and up, one more. Left leg up,
ribs are down.
And down. Bend the right leg, bend the left leg, and slowly roll all the way down. Roll down.
Lengthen those legs all the way forward, head, neck, and shoulders rolled up, and roll all the way forward towards your feet. Okay. So you have to experience